every search starts with a word, or more likely, a group of words. These words are called keywords, and keywords are at the heart of SEO. To rank high in search results, you need to identify the most important keywords or keyword phrases your potential customers are using to find your website, or more specifically, the individual pages on your website. And then you need to include those keywords on your web pages. There are two main types of keywords people typically type into Google or other search engines. The first is seed keywords. These are words relevant to most of your website or the main pages of your site. If you think of a plant, the seed is the starting point of how the plant grows. Seed keywords are the same type of thing. They're the starting point of most keyword research. The second type is long-tail keywords. These are several keywords or keyword phrases. Typically, these phrases are three or more words. Long-tail keywords are targeted and more specific. This generally means that searchers have an intent when they search. They're more likely to know what they're looking for and are closer to making a purchase or a decision. Let's look at some keyword examples. When a person is looking for snowblowers, they could be searching for how much do snowblowers cost, how do snowblowers work, or any number of things. But when somebody searches for battery-powered snowblowers, a long-tail keyword, you know they've already done some research and know they're interested in battery-powered snowblowers, not gas-powered. So they are more likely doing research on buying a battery-powered snowblower. So you would want to make sure to include that specific phrase on your web page because people searching using that keyword phrase are more likely to make a purchase. I recommend aiming for long-tail keywords because you will get visitors that are more targeted and ready to buy what you have to offer. And 91% of Google searches are long-tail keywords. When you plan your keyword strategy, consider what you have to offer and then think about the questions your customers would ask and the topics they want to learn about. Those things make great jumping-off points for your keyword research. And here's a pro tip. How questions are the most common type of question keyword phrases, followed by what, where, and who. Also, avoid jargon or uncommon industry terms that your consumers aren't familiar with. Think like they do and focus on keywords they would type in to find what you have to offer. For example, in the late 90s, I ran an online pregnancy and baby store. I was excited that my site ranked number one for keywords like pregnancy, pregnant, baby, and other keywords that received millions of searches. But I finally realized that those types of keywords were not the right ones because people searching for keywords like pregnancy weren't actually interested in buying pregnancy products. Most of them were searching for information about pregnancy. That was a big lesson learned. So I began optimizing my pages for long-tail keywords for the products I sold, like pregnancy body pillows, morning sickness remedies, and free shipping fertility monitors. Once I did that, I began to rank higher for products that I actually sold, and my sales went up. To industry professionals, large agricultural buildings are known as post-frame construction or post-frame buildings. When I was working to optimize a client's site, I did keyword research and discovered that most people searching for this type of building called these buildings pole barns. So let me show you how I did some research for this construction industry. Let's type in the word post-frame building. As you can see, there's only 2,400 searches per month for this search term. Now let's search for post-frame construction, which is another industry term. There's only 720 searches per month for that term. Now let's go ahead and search for pole barn. Wow, look at that. 90,500 searches per month in the US. If you had a company that built large buildings like this, which keywords would you write about on your website? Hopefully you'd choose the long tail keywords around pole barns. Here's a good example of a website that has great content that answers a what question, such as, what is a pole barn? and it ranks high on Google search results. Notice how they are also using the keywords pole barn in their URL. When you look at this web page, you can see how this site uses the keywords pole barn really strategically throughout the content of this page. When you're trying to determine the keywords to target for your website, be sure to also ask your salespeople and the people that answer your phones. As you do that, I recommend keeping a list of topics and questions customers are asking them, and then start using some of those topics and questions as keywords. Follow these 5 tips and you will have a great starting point to forming your keyword research strategy.